What's up, guys? Welcome back to the TenorShare channel. The iPad unavailable messages appears on lock screen after you enter worn passcodes many times. Briefly, the passcode is a security feature on iPad. If you do not enter the correct passcodes, you will see the iPad unavailable or security lockout screen, which means that iPad is locked to protect your data. The more times you enter wrong passcodes, the longer you're locked up, like 15 minutes and 1 hour. Below are the four most common methods to bypass it. So let's dive in. Method 1. Directly tap Erase iPad on the screen, iOS 15.2 or later. First, keep entering the passcode and see the Erase iPad option on the bottom right corner. Tap on it. Tap it again. Enter your Apple ID password. And then, the erase process will begin. Once done, you can set it up as a new device. If you don't have access to a network and you cannot remember your Apple ID, all you need is TenorShare 4 key. Connect your iPad to the computer. Hit the Start button to kickstart the process. Tap Next. If your iPad is undetected by TenorShare 4 key, you have to put it into recovery mode or DFU mode. This will ensure that it is detected. Then click Download the latest firmware file. After downloading the firmware package on your computer, tap Start to remove. Wait for a few minutes. Your passcode will be removed, and iPad unavailable messages will disappear. Method 3. Remotely erase iPad via Find. Open iCloud.com on a browser and sign into your Apple ID. Afterward, hit the Find My feature on the page. From the drop-down menu, you have to choose the locked iPad. Afterward, you have to click Erase iPad. Since no firmware is involved, this process could be pretty faster. And you will soon get access to your iPad again. Last but not least, you can also unlock your unavailable iPad with iTunes. Run iTunes on your PC, connect your iPad to it, and put your iPad in recovery mode. Once connected, click Restore to start the process to restore your iPad. The process will take around 15 minutes. Once completed, restart your iPad. Now, set up the iPad like a new device. That's all for today. Thanks for watching. For more tips like this, subscribe to the TenorShare channel. Or click another video to keep watching now. See you next time.